At the beginning, I mean, it was just the classical sports story because it was just, you know, rugby actions and then a little bit of life off the pitch. The story got published in the Globe and Mail during the Pride Week. It gained a discreet success, and then it went back, you know, in the bookshelf. So on Christmas 2015, I was in Italy visiting my family, and I got a call from one of the guys of the team, and he said to me, "Are you interested in continuing documenting the life of our team? Because we're heading to Nashville on May 2016. We're heading to the Bingham Cup. The Bingham Cup is the second largest tournament of the world within rugby. And so we would like you to come with us and document this event." So I had the chance to spend time with the guys on and off the pitch. And that's when I basically created that bond that allowed me to keep shooting. Muddy York is a particular team. It's an inclusive team. So you got all sorts of guys. The core of the team is gay, and then you got three guys that are straight guys and decided to play with Muddy York. Looking at the team, you got all the blend of the LGBTQs. Maybe they didn't have in their life the chance of playing sport because, you know, of the homophobic language that you can get in a regular locker room. So these guys, being accepted in an environment like that, were able to perform and be themselves doing basically what they like to do. For some of them, it's a love for the game. For some other, it was just the chance to be part of a bigger team, to feel part of a team. So I realized that I was doing something that was different from, you know, the original story that I started shooting for the Globe and Mail just right after the Bingham Cup, because, you know, after a month, I was able to go back to Toronto from Montreal and be with them during Pride. That experience and being with them during the parade and before the parade made me think what I was really doing. It wasn't just a story about the sport or rugby. It was showing the world, I would say, how these guys were somehow deconstructing and describing masculinity within the sport performance, which is something that is not accepted by everyone because we got stereotypes and we think that only certain kind of people can play specific sports while other ones cannot. Inclusion in sport, it's something that everybody should consider as natural, but it's not because not all the people are included in team sports. I'm thinking about hockey in Canada. I mean, it would be unthinkable to have a gay player in a hockey locker room, when inclusion will be something accepted by everybody, then there will be no longer the need for inclusive teams. If we think about the last Olympics, they had 56 athletes openly out, and it's a record. We gotta ensure that the next one, everybody that is, you know, gay or belonging to the LGBT community, he or she has to feel free to express that without any fear and without any concern. I mean, still, I think that there will be cases from particular countries in which these guys will not be able to do that, but that's the final goal.